When I got my first set of gouache paints, I really had no clue what to do with them. I'm not talking about how to use them, I'm talking about how to start with them. I did my research and I would see some artists just squeezing the tubes out on a very simple surface like this one, the same way we do with acrylics, and then throw away the rest. Some other artists would be using some like watercolor palettes and squeeze the tubes inside, let them dry and reactivate them the same way they would do with watercolors. And rarely I would see some using a wet palette like this one. At the time I couldn't find any real information on the subject, and now after all this time, after all my experience with gouache, I thought that I would make a video about this specific subject that I think is very useful for beginners and those of you who are still figuring out this medium. Now, I would like to begin by comparing the two main ways that gouache artists are working in, and that is one palette that is dry already. It is like a watercolor palette. You could take half pans or full pans, fill them with paint, wait for it to dry, and then reactivate it in order to paint again whenever you want to paint. The other way is more like acrylics. You just squeeze some paint on a surface and use it while it is still wet for one time use, let's say. Once you're done, you just clean your palette and move on to the next day or the next painting with fresh paint. You can combine the two, obviously, but I want to show you the different effects you can have with these ways so that you can decide for yourself and see what may not be working for you and why, so that you can fix it and try a different way, maybe. Now, when you leave gouache to dry in a palette like this, you can see that sometimes it cracks. It creates small particles like this that are very hard to dissolve afterwards within your brush, so sometimes you may have streaks on your paper. You can obviously throw this away and put some fresh paint on your palette and let it dry again, and so on and so forth. So that's not something that is not repairable if you're using this way, but it's something to keep in mind. Not all paints will do that. You can see here that some of them are pretty cool, pretty okay with how they are, but mainly what I want to talk about is the opacity of the paint. When you have your paint like that, you need water in order to activate it. So you dip your paintbrush in water and you try to reactivate one of these paints. It reacts like watercolor. You just take some of it, you use the water to reactivate it and have some paint on your brush. Now, the problem with this way is that no matter how hard you try or how little water you put on your brush and how much pigment you take on your brush, it's pretty impossible, actually it's extremely hard, if not impossible, to go back to the opacity that the paint originally had. No matter what I do, if I take this paint here and I just keep taking pigment on my brush, I will have an effect here that is watered down. You can see, I will take it closer to the camera too, you can see that it is a little bit transparent. It's not completely opaque. If you want the full opacity of gouache, this way will give you a hard time achieving that. You can have all the watercolor effects, you can activate your paint whatever way you like it, you can have mixing areas like this one the same way you would have with watercolors, and don't get me wrong, these are pretty cool effects and I am using it in my paintings every single time. I water down my paint and I take transparent layers and then put some paint on top and create some cool effects. You can even do the same cool, effects like that, the same way you would do with watercolors, pretty much, not exactly the same. And this is something very useful with gouache, and it's one of the reasons why it is such a cool medium. But I don't think that in this way you can get the full spectrum of the medium. Now, if you take paint straight from a tube and put it on an area like this, on a surface like this, you can choose not to use any water at all. You clean your brush, you dab it on a paper towel, you realize it is not clean, so you clean it again. You take off all excess water. You will barely have any brush that is completely dry, but that's okay because you can have the bristles the way you want them like that, but it is pretty much dry. It doesn't leave any water on the paper towel anymore. So now if I take a bit of paint and I put it on my brush like this, I can put it on the paper and have a completely opaque effect. It is not transparent at all. It has completely covered the paper. And it's the full consistency of my gouache. Especially when mixed with white, I won't even rinse my brush at this point. I will mix a nice pink with my white. And then put it on the paper. I could use some extra water, I choose not to. You can have a pastel light color, but still have it be opaque. Now, obviously there are two ways to go lighter with the color, either with water or with white, but these are two completely different effects you can have with gouache. And I think that's the magic of gouache as well, that you are able to use them either as watercolors or as acrylics, pretty much, in the same painting. Now, this palette also lets you water down your paint and have it both ways. You can use as much water as you want and have the transparent way of watercolor effects the same way you would with this palette. Again, there is no right or wrong way, and if you don't want to reach this opacity with your gouache, this way is a pretty cool way to use gouache. Also, with this palette, you don't throw away any paint. You just reuse it the next time and it doesn't go to waste. Even in this palette, you know already that I sometimes take the leftovers and use them for my underpainting on my next painting, which is pretty watered down, and then clean it, put some fresh paint on top and take this kind of opacity for my layers over the watered down layers. Also, this way is a much more portable way. If you're going outside to paint and you want your paints to be somewhere safe and in an easy way to take them with you, this is a much easier way to take paints with you, because if you have to carry every single tube with you and then have a surface to use the tube and clean your palette, and you know, it's not as easy. So there are benefits to this palette that you can't have in this way. So it does depend on the results you want, on the way you work, and what you value more with your painting. Also, obviously, as a combination of the two, since I started in this way because I thought it was the most popular way of using gouache, I assumed it was the right one for me, I would just paint as much as I could in this palette, and then when I wanted the full opacity, for especially for white highlights, because I couldn't figure out how they would cover underneath layers with white when I was using this kind of palette. No matter what I did, when I would go with white, go into my white, and take as much pigment as possible with my brush, I would go over a previous layer and I would get this. This is not bright white, this is mixed with a layer underneath, because it does have a little bit of extra water and the paint is watered down, plus it reactivates the layer on top of it, beneath it, and it creates a transparent kind of white streak, when what I really wanted was, let me show you, what I was watching other people do was take a little bit of white and create a streak that was actually bright. Whoops, sorry. White, like this one. And for quite some time, I couldn't figure out how other artists were getting this and I was getting that. Now, I kept using this palette, but in the end, when I was very close to the end, I wanted pretty opaque, bright highlights or details, I would just squeeze a little bit of extra paint on there and use it straight from the tube. In time, I realized that this was not the way to go for me, and I went straight here. So again, there are ways to combine the benefits of the two and decide for yourself what is best for you. I think that should pretty much cover the differences between the two palettes. Obviously, there are a lot of techniques, and I don't want to go into the details of the techniques here. I just wanted to show you the problems and the benefits of each way. Apart from these two, though, you have a third way to work, which is a wet palette. Now, this one is for miniature painting, but the way wet palettes work is pretty much the same anyway. You have a sponge here that is wet. I have put it under the sink and in the sink and watered it down. You can see maybe how much water it has here. You just leave it there, and then you take the paper they provide, which feels like the paper we use to bake in the oven. You can hear it too. You put it on top and squeeze it so that it absorbs some of the water underneath. Can you see the change because I squeeze it there and it absorbs some of the water? I guess it's visible in the camera. Here. In this way, when you put some paint in here, let's use this green, it works the same way as with this palette, but it stays wet longer. So I find that when I'm working inside, and especially during the winter, this is very much not necessary. But if you're painting outside and you have the sun hitting you, or maybe some heat and a little bit of wind, this moisture from underneath will keep your paints wet for much longer. It is the same way it works with acrylics, if you're using something similar with acrylics, but gouache can have some benefits from it too. So you squeeze your paints in here and you keep them wet for much longer. It is a little bit tricky to manage your water like that because it absorbs some water from underneath too, and you have to be careful with the amount of water you will use on your brush afterwards. And I also find that if I leave them in here overnight, not only they stay wet, but they become extremely watered down. I would leave the paint like that, and in the morning I would find a blob of paint pretty much this size and with streaks of water in it, and they would blend with each other and it would be just a huge mess here. Now, this is opaque paint now. Oh, it was water. Sorry, there was water underneath. It wasn't dry here, so it wasn't because of the palette, it was because of the paper not having dried out completely. This is a blob of paint that is here, opaque and thick. What I was saying? So yeah, if you leave it overnight, I think this is a hot mess. But if you're painting for quite some time and your sessions are long, for a few hours maybe, or if you're outside and you want the heat and the weather away from your paints and you want them to be wet for longer, this is a very nice way to go. So for some occasions, a wet palette is pretty convenient. You can create your own at home. You don't have to buy one. You can just have a sponge and the paper on top, and you can create the same effect with homemade wet palette, and it has the lid to go on top if you want to take a short break and you don't want leaves or dust to fall on top, and you keep them wet like that. I won't go into more details about that because I haven't really used it myself since I usually paint inside, but I experimented with it for a while to see if it was something that was convenient for me and if I could maintain my paints overnight to find them wet the next morning, but I found that it didn't work that well for this goal that I had in mind, but I can see how it can be useful for other occasions like the one I've mentioned. So there you go. Three palettes, three different ways of working, three choices you can make and the benefits and the downsides each method has. To sum it up, I use this way because I like the opacity of the paints. I can have the full spectrum of the gouache techniques with this palette, but it is a way to waste your paint. You have to throw it away, and it is not portable at all. Well, it's hard to take it with you in this way to get your tubes and your palette in a bag and go. With this palette, I feel that I lacked the opportunity to have the full opacity and thick texture of my gouache, but it is a very portable way, it is a very economic way because you use every single bit of paint you put in there and it is much easier to carry with you. And then with the wet palette, you can have your paints wet for much longer, you can take it outside, and if you are having very long painting sessions, maybe it is something that you might find useful. Try it at home, you don't have to buy one straight away because you may not like it and it would be a waste of money. That's all. If you have any questions, please leave them in the comments below. I will happily answer any of them. And if you'd like a different kind of subject or for gouache mainly or any other medium actually, also let me know in the comments below. If you liked this video, and I sure hope you found it useful, please leave a thumbs up before you go and share it with your friends because it would help my channel grow tremendously. Don't forget to subscribe to see more videos like this and hit the bell button to get notified whenever I upload a new video. I hope to see you in the next one. Until then, be safe, be happy, and keep going for your dreams. Bye.